like just covering the eyes, you know, like
no, it's like it's a, like a full face mask.
A full face mask. Okay.
Sorry, just a halfling or human wearing a mask. They're not on the hanging from a tree or anything, right?
No.
It's just them.
Okay.
Any details on like what they're wearing?
No, there's no details. It's very
so
generic.
So this one, is it very crudely carved or is it still very fine, like similar to the work that we saw?
It's very fine. They're all very fine, all the carvings that you've seen.
So they're not wearing anything as a carving, it's just like an outline
yeah.
of the body.
Yes.
I see, okay. Smiling mask. Are the faces the same?
What do you mean the faces? Body? Yes, they're all smiling.
Same kind of smile. It's not like one small smile, one big smile, one, you know? It's all the same.
All the same.
The
is
eyes,
it?
All the
yes,
same.
All the same.
Is it like some form of iconography that we'll recognize? Like you mentioned the Phantom of, like, the opera comedy tragedy mask.
For people who are more familiar with the theater, like maybe Isilia, who has watched some theater shows in her time, you would probably recognize it as a masquerade kind of mask. Very common opera masquerade mask.
I don't know, man.
I don't understand it.
What does this mean? Are they in disguise? Are they pretending to be happy when they're sad?
I mean, a masquerade is like a masquerade is they are pretending to be someone that they're not, right? So they're hiding the mask to be someone else, and they're wearing the mask to be someone else. So
what does the black stones, what do the black stones mean then? At least with the four men, there's some theme, like, oh, he's greedy or some shit.
White blindfold with black stones.
I mean, like, it's like, I don't know, I guess one can interpret it like they can't see even if they're not blindfolded. You know what I mean? It's like they're misled or something. It's like they're not seeing or they don't want to see the truth or whatever, even if they were not blindfolded.
Coals for eyes? Was it supposed to be coals? But it was hard to get coals, so it got stoned in.
And then painted it black.
Why?
Painted black. It's specifically, it's meant to be black.
Yeah.
It's not like random stones.
What does it mean?
It's specifically meant to be black, meaning...
But what do coals for eyes represent?
I don't know.
Is there a meaning to it?
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know. In this world, would that...
We had gold for eyes, right?
We have gold for eyes.
Coal.
Now we have black
the poor, yeah.
balls for eyes.
The rich, the poor.
I did mention that I did mention that the when you examine the triumvirate bodies, that you probably did lose a bulk of the evidence because the bodies were so badly burned.
Who had gold eyes again? The four men, right?
Yeah.
Oh yes, the four men. So his theme was gold, right?
Like, Trembit were like hangmen, executioners.
Yeah. All right, to the ruins we go. Let's
what
go to
the
ruins right now.
On the foreman?
Scale, unbalanced scale with what seems like gold on the heavy side.
Okay. Yeah.
Then we have mummers.
So like bribery, not bribery, but like greed, like you mentioned.
Let's do a quick break and then go to the ruins.
I think we might be interpreting this wrongly, right?
Okay,
the judge?
I don't know.
Executioner. The first one's the executioner. Second one's the judge.
I don't think so.
Then the third one is what?
Performer, the jester.
It was just a scale, right? I mean...
Hmm.
I don't know.
Hey, while we are contemplating, I'll search the house. Or someone smart, search the house.
Give me an investigation check.
Someone, I say someone smart, search the house.
You called it, man, dude.
I mean, I want to be searching the house anyway. For sure.
Sure. One. Okay, either one of you can do it with advantage.
I will.
Mine is plus 3 though.
I'm so tired from the poison gas I inhaled. It's okay, you do it.
Oh, okay.
I want to see if I get
a. There is what appears to be a ledger that you do find beneath a false bottom in one of the drawers.
Pog.
Clue.
A ledger of some sort. Upon closer inspection, it would appear that the ghosts were smuggling slaves out of the city.
Okay.
Through different kinds of routes. And also attempting to or successfully hijacking the Triumvirate's trade routes. And procuring supplies of their own.
That sounds like a good thing.
How long do these ledgers date back to?
This has been going on for about 3 to 4 years. From what you can tell.
Does it coincide with the time that the vampire took control? Because the vampire took control only like 2 years plus, right?
Yeah. So it probably started before then because this dates back quite a bit.
Yeah, and they also know that they were also the ones to advise that maybe the Triumvirate was, you know, under someone's control. So they probably predate Kadir. But you know what frustrates me?
Well, but Kadir was the one that was controlling the Triumvirate, right?
Yeah, so the Ghost Network were operating even before Kadir showed up. That makes sense.
In the ledger also describes the known identities of the 5 co-founders of the Ghost. They also have the racial identities: 2 halflings, 3 humans.
Right. Any of those names ring familiar?
None of them ring familiar to you.
Safe to say the leaders are right before.
When was the last entry?
Last entry was 1.5 weeks back, where they intercepted a trade of spices.
You know what's very frustrating to me? Everything feels like the next leader consolidating power. But we zone of truth. Right.
Yeah, we zone of truth Flynn and he said.
Yeah, nothing to do.
What if it's not, it's really not Flynn, but someone else who knew what was going on. Maybe he bought Tlin's secret. And maybe he is consolidating power, which is why, you know, I don't know, they are against Tlin ascending to the throne.
Ghost, the 4 men.
But why the 4 men though? Foreman shouldn't be a threat to.
I mean, you didn't roll well at all last session when you tried to investigate the foreman's office. It was trash rolls, if I recall.
Oh, it's so stressful. I feel like we leave. we come back or we get word 3 months later that like Flynn's dead.
Flynn is dead.
Yeah. No shot he survives.
And this is even more concerning, right? That Alia will be a target.
No, Alia best leave this shit alone, you know.
I mean, if he's going so far as to silence a four man. If he's ready to consolidate power, then no matter how adamant Alia is to...
She has a claim, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. No matter how adamant she is that she's not interested.
To the ruins we go.
What do you want to do there?
Yeah, I want to the
we
ruins.
Can't get through the barrier.
Can we not? Could we not just open the door for it?
Huh?
We tried, but...
I thought we turned away.
No, oh, it was this golden barrier. Dome glass thing.
It's like same as the library.
Yeah. Oh. I mean, I feel like we need to find out. Oh man. I mean, okay, we are still not totally out of leads. If we can go back to the secret selling guy and find out who bought Tillin's secret. Maybe that could be a lead.
Good. That would be at the bazaar at night.
Yeah.
We're done with day, you know. We're done with the house, more accurately.
I guess there's nothing else we can do here, right? We should report this to Flynn. Maybe he has an idea of if someone's really consolidating power, who it could be.
Yeah, I guess we should let Flynn know this guy has, if I'm not wrong, killed 11 people already.
And? Then right, who else he killed? Triumvirate, Handmaiden, four men, and then these
random,
five.
Random slave. Okay, that's indirectly.
All right. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, intentionally he killed 10.
Yeah. Oh my
god. It's very good. It's very good. It will hit this.
But this is clearly not part of the pattern. The first murder that happened where we found the corpses, right?
Eh? No, it's not. Why would it be different?
The foreman wasn't killed in the house that we found him in. Neither were the triumvirate and the handmaiden.
I mean, all this stuff we don't know, right? It's not important. It's the house to put them in and the door to trap. I think that's the more important one.
I don't know. Maybe. Or maybe not. Considering that seems like these five dudes were killed more recently than the rest. I don't know, was it like a last minute change of plans? How long has it been since we killed Kadir?
Maybe 2 days? since you killed Cardia?
It seems like the Triumvirate and four men got killed around the same time. And... wait, 2 days only?
Mm-hmm.
We spent 1 day traveling to the Oasis to bring me back, and then another day to come back here. And then one more day to install Flynn.
Alright, so probably three then. Counted wrongly. 3 days. In total. Wouldn't really. Yeah, 3 days.
Gosh.
Slightly. The Triumvirate got killed the same night that we killed Cardia.
So does
but
that.
These guys.
That, like, we were really suspicious of this ghost network, but I guess it wasn't them. So, what does that mean? Has there always been this other party that we just didn't know of, and they somehow knew everything and decided to act the moment like things happen? Like opportunity presented itself.
Seems like it.
How do we even deal with something like this?
I don't know, but how does he even know that the Triumvirate were rescued?
Yeah.
If it's not the ghosts.
Yeah, like.
Unless he was working with Cardia.
No way.
But like, how would they know, right? Because the time between us plotting and actually going down to rescue the Triumvirate, no one should really have known exactly like what's gonna happen.
I mean, the Triumvirate was not even part of the plan, right? We just happened to find them and
yeah, precisely.
Send them out.
That's super weird. Like, do you think if we didn't bump into the Triumvirate and set them free, do you think they would be alive? Was it really just like a coincidence that whoever did this managed to find them? But it just... I don't know. It feels like we probably won't be able to find who this person is. I don't think they will...
Not without more information, at least.
Yeah, or if... Unless they want to be found. They are leaving all these little clues, but... you know.
Yeah.
It's more like they're just taunting us.
Yeah. If they wanted to really, you know, get rid of loose ends, they could just get rid of the corpses entirely, right? Why let us find them?
Yeah, like we could have just not known anything at all.
Let's go tell Tlin first. There's nothing else we can do, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You make your way back to the palace where you find Tlin in his office working on some documents, kind of like, as he sees you step in, he's like, ah, did you come from the foreman's apartment? What did you find?
The apartment? I question.
As in the apartment where he was killed.
Yes, we did. We also found 5 more corpses.
Excuse me? 5 more?
Yes, I just sound off the names that we found in the ledger, the 5 founders' name, and
see names if Clint listens to the names. These don't really ring a bell, honestly speaking. Never heard of them before.
Looks like you have a serial killer on your hands.
I asked him.
Did you manage to find out who killed the 5 people and the 4 men? Any clues or anything that might help me in this investigation, at least?
If you were the head of state, I'm sure you would have, you know, someone or some people to gather information that could be helpful to
I am on it. I will get on it, but
no, I'm asking. 5. When the Triumvirate were still in power, who is that person?
Gather information, as in what kind of information are we talking about gathering?
I'm talking about, if you will, an intelligence agency.
What is an agency?
Like, you know, someone who conducts
investigation. I would be in charge of conducting said investigations. Yes.
What if these investigations need to be, you know, on the down low, behind the
down
scene?
Low.
What if?
I mean, I am pretty good at investigating myself. I've not really dabbled in serial killers before. And I would have to say I'm pretty decent at investigating, if you know what I mean. I've solved a few cases in my time.
Did you know that the Triumvirate's trade routes were being hijacked?
No. What are you talking about exactly?
Did you know that slaves were being smuggled out of Valhar?
He looks confused.
Not a very good investigator, are you?
Well, things are happening in your city now. Good luck.
You're gonna just leave me and just drop this information on me and leave?
Sweetie, it's your city.
Shit.
I don't know, how should I put this? People of interest in Valhar are dying, being killed. We don't know by who. We don't have any more information. Unless there's anything you want to share with us. Like, the secret that you
told. There's someone who is trying to gain power in this city. We have no idea who that be, because we're not from here. But so far, the people they've managed to off, 10 and possibly counting, seem to have had a hand in shaking things up. Trade routes, slavery, triumvirate themselves. Seems to be an overarching theme. So we want you to know about it so that you can get yourself or your best men on it. Because frankly, at this point in time, it doesn't look good for you. Given that now you have taken the seat of power, you very likely would be the next person this serial killer is going to come after. I don't know if they will be so bold to go after you. They certainly went after the Triumvirate only after they were, you know, in a more vulnerable state. So perhaps you'll be much more protected at this point and not be as easy of a target. But that certainly seems to be pointing towards that direction. I don't know who would want to gain power. That is, I would assume you would have that knowledge and not us, because you've lived here your whole life. You would know if there are certain houses or royals or whoever who have always been kind of conniving or, you know, sneaky or sly, or, I mean, these things you would know best. Like, we come from outside of the city. We wouldn't know the inner workings of your political, you know, party and power struggle and, you know, all that kind of thing. Like, we couldn't give you a name. This is what is happening. It looks like they're going after people who have been either vying for or playing with the power in the city. So now that you are in power, I mean, put two and two together.
He looks,
that's all we can do,
mildly concerned. And can see he's nervously like kind of tapping on the table, like
whoever is doing this has been leaving messages as well.
You know, I just had a thought, but I'm gonna save it for after we deal with him. This is a private
part. Are you speaking in character or not?
Yeah, I'll say that maybe later. I'll bring this up.
Should we share what we found on the corpses?
I think,
out of character.
I think we should just throw everything at him. Even the stupid journal that we found, the ledger. Just give him everything. If he runs the fucking secret intelligence and doesn't know half the things we know, then he's gonna need all the help he can get, man.
Okay.
You unload all the information to him, and he takes a long time to process what you are saying, and furiously scribbles down notes as you speak.
Mental breakdown, huh?
Who is smart here, Tlin?
Huh?
Like, who in do you know in the city who is just a really?
Who do you fear in the city?
It would fear me the most, honestly.
There you have it.
Then why did you need our help to install you as the leader of Valhalla in the first place? You're so scary.
Yeah, I mean, if no one is going to dare to go up against you, then you could have just taken it. You know what I mean? Like, why... Did you need to convince if you could just scare everyone into submission?
Every good ruler requires a strong support. He nods.
Oh, is he really as stupid as he's making himself out to be?
Yeah, I'm gonna inside check and see whether he really thinks. Like... Yeah.
Okay, let me inside check.
Can I roll it?
Yeah, you roll. Okay, is he? He's
okay. Good enough.
He's 100. Okay, the both of you. He is so full of himself. He genuinely believes that he's a great guy.
Dude, I don't know, man. Like,
he genuinely believes that he's the man for the job and he can.
Best of luck to you.
Yeah.
Okay. Well.
But.
Yeah. We shared all we've known, and I don't know. This, we really have to kind of start to get back to Evereska.
Yeah. I still would really love to see the books, though. Just FYI.
That was not. I mean.
Why not, right? At this point.
Oh, wait, I just remember about Hidden Strike.
He's around.
Okay, okay. He's just with us this whole time.
He's like, oh shit, five corpses? Yeah, fuck
we
yeah.
We did talk about, like, he would join us. Like,
yeah. Yeah. With regards to the books, could we do this privately without your friends here? Mm-hmm. I mean, from one intelligent person to another intelligent person, I'm sure you understand the importance of privacy.
Yes, okay.
I smug sure. at you, Celia. Oh, you're sure. so intelligent.
Sure, I completely understand. Fine.
Okay, I admit I'm not smart.
Well, let's move to the other channel. It's the four, then exit the room.
Oh, what does it mean?
Why? It's just books.
God damn. Goodbye.
I don't get it. Is this something that we should be pursuing?
Is it just like
a really inconsequential side quest?
I feel like confirm got consequence, but it's like it also feels like we can't like
waste too much time on it.
Yeah, plus like what the fuck are we supposed to do? Ayo.
I mean, we are still not out of threats to pull. But like you said, like, we don't know whether we should spend so much time on it or not. Maybe in-game time is not that long, but... What do you think?
Don't know.
Faravan, do you think we should continue pulling on the threats?
I think, right? It's very simple.
What?
We wait for Marion to get back.
We wait for one more day and then find a few more corpses.
Else of interest are there? Is there left in Valhalla? The Mist Shadow people are dead, but that's due to the giant, right? Ghost people are dead. Foreman is dead. Triumvirate dead. Gogal, do you think Gogal will be dead?
Oh, that's a good point.
No, no one kills a character like Gogal, because no matter who's in charge, someone like that's useful. He's the arms dealer that plays to all sides.
Makes you think if he has any information on what's going on.
No way he'll speak. Or no way he'll even know. Like, the stuff you we engage him for, he doesn't know what we get up to also.
You could say that, but I'm sure he might have theories. If anything, I don't know. If it's someone that's threatening enough, maybe he will, you know, leak something to save himself. What is Tlin's secret that he's so unwilling to share?
I don't think it's super important. To the main plot.
To the main plot is in the Mask Elves. Or to this
side. To anything really.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I think it'd be very stupid if we push so hard for this secret and then we find out it's like some really mundane shit like he hates his mom's cooking or something.
It might just be.
I cannot be why he's sold for so much money. Okay, I go toilet also. Wow. She's
okay.
Reading books.
big sad. Too dumb.
Pathfinder on a massive discount.
Pathfinder?
Wrath of the Righteous.
Wish I could Pathfinder around this whole serial killer mess. No more! Fuck!
Do we buy this game? Do I buy this game? It's $20. Tempting, eh? Tempting.
Can tide you through until
Baldur's Gate finally comes out.
I feel like we said that for almost a year.
We said that when the last Modern Warfare came out. And now we have Modern Warfare 2-2.
Modern Warfare 2-2.
Okay, like $20, just buy the whole.
Wow.
Can the treasury bear such an expense?
Yeah, it's like one alcoholic beverage.
I don't know where you think I drink. It's definitely not once, two.
Okay.
Oh, so many things to read on.
What thing?
Yeah.
It's still here.
She's just actually just going ham on the books.
Why cannot let us know? Be some secrets.
Yeah, maybe. I think I won't enjoy Pathfinder because it's not D&D 5th edition.
Pathfinder.
Yeah, I think wait for Baldur's Gate. Wait for Baldur's Gate.
Baldur's Gate.
Baldur's Gate.
Baldur's Gate.
Too many games that I would like to play.
When is MW2 supposed to come out?
Soon.
That means next year already, right?
Well, this year, October, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Like a few more weeks.
Maximum is November, and they always release November. Should be October, mid-October. MW2 is must play on. Not even talking about the multiplayer, I just want to play the story.
That's a long conversation that they're having.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
What does it mean?
They're still talking.
They are.
You're having intelligent people only conversation.
Can't help but feel like Tlin is a mistake.
Yes lah. But Cypher is too like naive to worry about that. And Cameron doesn't really care. But if not him also, very hard to say who's the, you know, better choice, you know?
That's true. Make them fight for leadership.
Hello! Oh. Wow, sorry.
Oh, that's a lot of books to read, huh?
Long talk.
Tlin and Isuya leave his office, and Tlin says, "I will see you later, Isuya." And he walks down the stairs.
What the heck means see later? We're leaving, Isuya?
Oi. Well, I didn't know you have so many things to talk about, Isuya.
It was a long talk. It was about 20 to 30 minutes long.
Wow.
How long you waited outside.
Damn.
We almost left without you.
Yeah, silly, what was that about?
Oh, as he's leaving, I'll ask him like, where do I meet him?
Ask him what?
He didn't say like, I'll see you later.
He just, he'll whisper to you, if you just hang around here, it won't be very long.
Okay. Big sus.
No, none of you heard that.
Okay. So I'm gonna stay for a bit. Cause there's some records that I should take a look at.
Wait, well, what's this about? Is this concerning? Should we be concerned? Or... Feels like there's something going on between the two of you.
No. I mean, it'd be good for us to know, but I need to help him find it. And
all right.
Absolutely
what?
Concerning what we suspect about.
All right. We trust you.
The connection of the three. Okay, so I'm going
connection
to
of the what? Sorry,
Tree City.
So I'm going to do my best, help him, because he really is a clueless kid. Like God bless his soul. But if we can find a copy, it would shed so much light. I hope. I'm hoping.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
But he does not want you guys to know. So just please pretend like.
Sure. You're not going to tell us. Why would you do that? Yeah.
I'll meet you later. I couldn't keep it from you guys if I tried. Okay, goodbye. Bye. I'll see you later.
What?
What time is it?
Clean returns and it is mid-afternoon.
Okay.
You need to make me an investigation check with advantage. As you pour through the library as well as the Triumvirate's quarters over the next few hours.
Please, let it be good. Oh my god!
One with advantage.
Pause champ.
Now you can retroactively roll advantage by clicking the button.
Ayo!
Okay, other channel, one second.
Oh, here we go again.
No shot, shit.
Okay, but this is progress.
Yes.
Progress, yeah.
Finally, something to link the three cities.
Damn, they're talking for a very long time.
So many things to talk about, eh?
It's the law, man. It's law dumb. The law dumb we almost didn't get to.
GM feeling generous.
Just that, cannot deal with the 8 in team, really.
The what?
The 8 in team. Everyone 8 in.
Is there any feat that gives proficiency to investigation?
Yeah, of course. There's a lot of ways to get it, just then none of us.
I'm surprised Isilia didn't get it.
yeah.
She's not really like, she's book smart, right?
And I'm negative intelligence, so...
Most of us are.
At least I'm not. I purposely put in points to intelligence for flavor, but one is not enough. I could have min-maxed and gone 16 con, but I'll be stupid.
Yeah, it might be needed later, but not at a like starting level character. You saw my rogue stats, right?
I cannot remember. Like
110 health at the end of the campaign.
You went con midway, is it?
I just took the feat that doubles your health.
Wait, there's such a feat?
Yeah, it's called tough. You retroactively add your like every level, right? You gain double the con and you apply retroactive.
Oh, sounds like a kind of a must take, no?
Not really, if you don't get hit. Why they get?
Tankiness is always good.
You're not like, I mean, it depends lah. It's a feat after all. It's very expensive. But if you're going to pump con, I'd rather take that feat.
Oh, it goes to twice your level. So you don't just gain like one extra hit dice roll, right?
No, you don't. It's like a con bonus, but it applies backwards. If you do the math, it's the exact same as like all the way you had extra,
right?
Extra health. So it's better than, yeah.
It's +2 to every level lah.
Yeah lah, it's better than taking a constitution modifier and doesn't apply backwards.
Yeah. You only lose on the con save. Which I guess... with your aura is good enough.
Yeah. Fun. Yeah, no proficiency in con.
I cannot, my class already so mad. I got time to take feats.
Oh.
My HP very behind the curve, eh. I only got 42.
I beg.
Very nice.
Look at Marin's face.
Sorry.
Okay.
Huge.
The four of you, what are you doing? Because Marin's preoccupied until about 8 p.m.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Do we know that? Or are we just fucking waiting outside? Because she said it'd just be a minute.
Yeah, no, what the hell is going on?
I'll meet up with you guys later. I thought you like just go first. I'll find y'all.
I mean, we don't have anything to do until the bazaar opens anyway.
Yeah, I'm just
gonna be working on my wooden fucking swords then.
Yo, what's that about?
Don't tell you.
Yeah, I see Casgraph carving his wooden swords again. Like,
I feel so like deeply uncomfortable in this city that I really just hanging around, you know?
Yeah, I really just want to get the fuck out, but yes, Casgraph will just keep on keeping.
You do
on.
See if Isilia eventually.
I suppose now would be the time where I discuss why I think, like, without really waiting for.
Okay, go ahead.
I think we're overthinking this. I think our enemies wanted to destabilize this great nation of Moha. And I think that they are doing exactly that. Right, remember the original plot is that the allies of Avraska need to be crippled in some way. So we kind of, I wouldn't say made a mess at Greyholm, but we didn't exactly leave them in a super fighting, you know, fighting condition, right? Or maybe that was a success, but, you know, Shelby did get the worst end of it. But here we pretty much almost fixed everything, right? Triumvir will be at full power. They have their undead army, they would send help.
Makes no sense, then why leave those cryptic messages?
That's just like a cultist thing to do, right? That's just
cultist thing to do.
That's exactly what like crazy confessor dudes do, right? If you think about it, the kind of capabilities of this adversary is like beyond.
Really? I think the crazy confessor thing to do is to disintegrate your foes.
Sure, but like, I'm sure they employed someone to do it, right? But like, their capabilities are obviously elevated, right? And who has access to this kind of information and expertise? It has to be, right? But then I just don't understand where Ethelwine sits on this whole axis. On one hand, she's aligned with the Mars Elves and the Eight. On the other end, not really.
Let's just go back to Avraska.
As you are having this conversation, you see Isilia come down the stairs.
Alright, let's leave.
Oh, that took some time. What did you learn?
Oh, we'll leave this place with.
Yeah, let's leave it.
Ruins.
Are we not going to the bazaar?
We are.
Okay.
Are we staying? Are we no longer staying at the inn?
Do we want to spend another day here?
Could I potentially go and rest while this is happening? Like, I just don't go to the bazaar and I just go
and
rest.
It's only 3-4 hours. I mean, you don't want to go to the bazaar, you don't have to go lah. Then you can rest lah. But I mean, you will still get a long rest because you're only leaving at dawn, right? Are we leaving at dawn or are you going to leave straight away?
Okay, well, if we're leaving at dawn, then yeah. I guess I will wait.
I'll leave it up to you guys. I don't know. What's your plan.
Yeah. Dawn sounds good.
Hey, so are you guys ready?
God.
I walk in and talking.
Tell me.
So, the whole thing. God. So we know that there's been an agreement between these three cities way back in the day, right?
Why are you whispering? I can't hear
yeah.
you.
Yeah, I have to turn up my volume.
Oh yeah, sorry. Well, I'm whispering.
He's whispering.
So basically, the agreement, I managed to find it. Oh my god, it was signed like so long ago, like at the end of Everestus' first High Lord's rule. It was like,
wait, that's the guy we met.
Huh?
That's the dead guy we met.
In yes. The Grey Home.
Ask him, hey yo.
Yes.
Hey yo, what's up?
Oh.
We can go back there.
Oh, Valhar.
Oh wait, we did try. I think we did try to ask
Grey
him.
Clock
he was
Hills,
like...
Grey Clock Hills, Grey Clock Hills, and the in the tomb.
Yeah, the Narodis Analog.
Okay, okay.
He tried to kill us, remember?
So, basically what it says, so it was like the Triumvirate really stashed it real deep, man. Like nobody could find this thing.
Damn, you need to wash your hands.
I know. So this agreement, basically signed by the three rulers of Valhar, Everest, and Greycloak, it says that Valhar and Greycloak Hills promise to defend, protect, and seal the city of Netherreal for an eternity. So do you remember like the weird visions we got in like in the desert? There was a city. It was real. It was
no, that
thing.
Was not Netherreal, right?
I think that it was, because it says for an eternity, because the calamity caused by that city created the magical desert of Anorak. It was here. Don't know what happened, like shit hit the fan and it just, I guess, like wiped like everything. So Everesca pledged a source of endless water to Valhar. Pledged to create the Ward Mist, Ward for Greycloak, and created this thing called the Shan Wall, which would defend the three cities. So basically, there's something in Everesca. We found one in Greycloak Hills, and then now we found one here. So the thing that we can't go past is called Shan Wall.
What was the thing we found in Everesca? We didn't find anything in Everesca.
But it's there. It literally says it will create a Shan Wall which will defend the three cities. So one can assume that there's a Shan Wall that exists in Everesca somewhere deep down, like we don't know. Like everything has been underground, right? So I'm assuming it's below the city of Everesca, like wherever. I don't know. But I'm sure it exists. I'm so sure. I'm sure with every fiber of my being.
Hold on. If they're trying to, I don't know, isolate this city of... You're saying this Netherreal is a city?
Yes. It becomes...
Why do you need the Shan Wall in three locations then?
No. They are sealing Netherreal.
They're keeping something at bay, right? So Clint said that when he was a boy, like 40 plus years ago, when he was just a scribe, he was in a meeting with the king of Valhar at that time, which was the Triumvirate's father, along with Tlin's father, because he was the chief advisor and the head of an army, of the army, which is this person called Ogden something, but he doesn't remember like the last name of this person.
Ogden? Like,
O-G-D-E-N? Ogden?
Yeah, it sounds familiar.
So they were discussing...
Shouldn't be familiar, yeah, I have not used this name before.
They were discussing about potentially making amendments to this agreement. I don't think it was raised up to Everesca ever, but they were saying that if the creatures, and they used the term, if the creatures were unleashed upon the realms of men, like, the consequences would be, like, so dire. And apparently, like, if everyone banded together, like, with all the magics and whatever we had, like, it wouldn't matter. It wouldn't... In less than 2 days, like, everything would be shot to hell. So... They are keeping an entire city at bay, filled with I don't know God knows what.
No, you're getting it wrong.
That's what I read.
The agreement. City is sealed. But yes. They're separate from the Shan Wall. Shan Wall was created to defend
the two cities.
So the Shan Wall...
The three cities.
Yeah. Assuming the one that we don't know about. So the creatures are beneath this Shan Wall and can be... like release to so-called defend their proxy nations. But then I'm sure the people in the meeting 40 years ago are kind of worried, like, hey, maybe what if they are not using this to defend us, what if they use it against us? So maybe they wanted to, like, hey, this agreement, maybe we want out, we don't need this protection anymore.
I think you're confusing yourself.
No, absolutely not. If the creatures were unleashed upon the realms of men, so this seal is keeping these creatures from coming out, because if they were to come out, devastation will occur.
Oh, you said they were, you said that they created the Shan Wall to protect these cities.
Correct, which is what is holding the creatures, this thing right? Okay. At bay. Exactly.
Okay. Okay.
This city in the Netherreal, called Netherreal. Can I, do I know, like, did that ping anything? Like,
no.
When I read
me,
that?
Me? Me?
Okay. No.
So yes, so holy
in,
shit.
In your history books that you have read, the two of you, there's not been any mention of a city called Netherreal.
Inclin did mention that people will kill for this information. Like, but if this information has never been talked about, like, I don't know who, like, maybe this Octon person, he's still alive somewhere or something. Like, he left the city a while back. He, like Clint said, he left the city with his family or something like that before all this vampire nonsense. So, yeah, right? Like, that raised, like, such a big red flag. So, Clint's father is dead. The king of Valhalla is dead. Like, the only person who was part of that conversation was this head of army guy called Ogden and Clint himself and someone who was a cup holder, and then now I didn't ask that name, which is so stupid, but I'm hoping
holder.
Someone
like, he's the cup bearer. He said he's the scrap and cup bearer.
Oh, okay, yeah. So
cup bearer.
So, yeah. So now there's one person unaccounted for in that meeting between the council of Valhar that were talking about agreement. So there's one person out there who knows about this agreement, who is not here.
So,
yeah.
This confirms everything that we have terrorized.
We have a name. We have a name of the thing now.
The Shan Wall.
Of the city.
Oh, Netherreal.
Yes.
Damn.
And pledges a source of also, endless water. What does that mean? So like
that means the Qing creatures are yeah.
From
the Everest. Yeah, horrible people. Honestly, why would you do that?
Like the wait.
Yeah.
The ones that you worked at?
Yeah.
Provided by Everestka.
That adds up, yeah. Damn.
Okay.
Now what? Did they say how we can... Okay, I guess we shouldn't open the Shan Wall.
I guess
we shouldn't.
No,
it doesn't
yeah.
sound like it.
It sounds, like, sounds really bad.
Yeah.
Wait, so does that mean the mass elves are trying to
concern,
crack it open?
I guess the concern now and the reason why like what's the face is being so testy is because of like the mithril nonsense, like everything is kind of being like becoming unstable or whatever.
Yeah.
Like yes, the wall could be weakening.
It is, that's the whole point. Yeah, of them. Yeah, the mass elves are Netherrealians.
Are they?
But that would make sense, right?
Because they have access to all these like levels of magic or like devices or whatever that we have never seen before.
Yeah.
Elden
Ring, there's that buried city.
How about this king,
what?
The word of power, how does that play into this whole...
What?
Your brother!
The word of power, yeah, the king.
The king!
Oh!
Shit, I forgot about that bloodline altogether.
I don't know! I wish I knew. Well...
Our working theory is he's supposed... The supposed king, right? That...
He's that, the king of that city?
That represents the eight, the king of the eight figures.
No. We don't know if the eight actually are from Netherreal, right?
Yeah,
but I feel like it's close. It's a good guess.
Because.
Why are they all fae?
When we saw, right? Like me and you, Oracles, we saw visions, and
yeah,
it was
too.
Like a city that was. Shut up. We know you did. You're just not telling us, which is so annoying. But we saw. Like a city that was so far advanced than what we've ever seen, and
it can't be Netherreal, right? Because
it is though.
But Netherrealm is a bad thing, right? It basically turned that city into Onarok.
No, the city is called Netherrealm.
And something happened and
something, like some, like people in the city or something, like did something that was so bad that created Onarok. I don't know whether it means it wiped it out and then like buried them, like, you know, Atlantis or some shit. Like, I don't know. I mean, yeah, okay.
But we saw humans in the city, right?
Only humans. Yeah, a human city.
Yes. But they certainly had magic. Certainly had magic.
Yes.
Something was here. This desert was not a desert. Like, did you know this? It was a city before. It was this city.
Did you find anything about the writing on the wall?
No, it didn't say anything about that. It was just it was just the agreement saying that this is what is promised, what will be done by Evereska, and in turn, Valhalla and Grey Cloak will defend and protect, and essentially prevent anything from coming past them.
Okay, but it aligns with what the three walls. And the writing on the wall mentioned three walls as well. But we always assume it was, I mean, I guess it is, because we always thought it was holding a creature or something, right? Like one that sealed it, one with eyes and teeth. But what does that mean? Like, is it just three big things that we are preventing with this wall? Control the ones. Okay.
It's sealing off a city, and then at the same time, Clint heard them talk about creatures being unleashed, like multiple. So I don't know whether it could very well mean three creatures in each city.
Oh, okay.
Or the entire city. Like, I have no idea.
Well, that okay. Well, at least we kind of know why we are doing all of this now. But it also really scary. So that means these must elf people are trying to destroy the world.
Or be free.
Okay, okay.
Are they must? Because they are. But we unmasked them and then they were like elves, right?
Yeah.
Regular run-of-the-mill elves.
Yeah.
Aside from the weird heart tattoo stuff. What is that? What is that? What's the heart stuff? Come on.
We just dog nose.
Dog nose?
I feel like we're more confused now than before.
Some answers, a lot of questions.
Is Adeline good or not?
Just a dog nose.
Maybe if she shut down the sun, then the Netherreal cannot be free.
Let's just go back ever.
Maybe if she Eternal Winter, then Netherreal cannot be free.
Honestly.
Maybe Eternal Winter is a metaphor. Maybe it doesn't mean that winter lasts forever. Maybe it means that the winter in our hearts never goes away.
Yeah, alright, dude.
Well,
okay, well,
I don't know. But this looks like a main quest kind of storyline that will take another 20 sessions to
reach. So then, does this change anything with
Vu? She gave a thing to say. Main quest
unlocked. Gotta check Steam for your percentage, then you can estimate like how much more to go.
Yeah, so does this change anything? Like, whatever we sought to do in Valhalla, it's
done, right? Yeah.
The last of the bazaar, but what were we planning?
That was it, right? Like, just get the identify stuff done, then leave with the aid of
him. I mean, if you're not gonna care about Tlin and his secret and who's killing all these people,
can we do?
Fuck him.
We can go and find the secret seller now and find out who bought the secret. A lot of things, right?
I think the fact that Tlin is kind of incompetent or not the most competent or not exactly a warmonger sort of guy, it's gonna work to his advantage. It's gonna let him be alive for a bit more.
Oh my god, you know what would be so funny? We sell what we just learned as a secret, and then someone buys it, and they're like, I'm kidding, dude. Don't fucking do that. I mean, probably worth a lot.
Buy the Scroll of Wish, maybe, yeah.
Can I buy the Scroll of Wish? But like, you break it, part 1, part 2, part 3. You put that a bit, then you're like, oh, you want the next one, huh? You want the next one? It's not a secret because we 5 know.
Oh, that's true. Okay, yeah, okay. Yeah, it is better that way. We should never entertain the idea.
Yeah, who would think of such
and a... In that case, it wouldn't have been a secret.
A lot of people
that
out.
Because it's known to people.
That was the secret that Clint told.
We could like wrestle the buyer.
It did cross my mind, but like...
But
damn man, he must have been truly desperate to give that secret because he was like, if you tell this to your party, like they're all gonna fucking die, like do it like this needs revelation. So I doubt that he would. I doubt that this would be what he would say. I don't know.
He probably doesn't really understand what the hell he just
gave.
The
gravity of it, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Something that we've been occupied with for months, like our entire quest is centered around it.
Yeah. Well,
okay, but what's the work? So, what do you think of the working theory that the mass elves are behind the killing? I feel like that's the only.
That's the only thing that remotely makes sense. But
Etelwine left some agent of chaos behind to say that, hey, you know, if things go too well for these cities, just start killing people who are important. Meanwhile, I've got to take this pet project away to the Forgotten Forest or whatever. Or Etelwine is not really with the Mass Elves.
Honestly, no idea. I don't think there's any point in us going back and forth for like hours anymore on this. There's too much to assume and not enough answers to strike them off.
Why did we tie Etelwine to the Mass Elves?
Because she's the one. Yeah.
She's
the one that commissioned the pot.
And she's an elf, and she fucking took the Acosta, and Acosta had the pot. It all just adds up, right? Like, why would she?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
And we know that the Mars Elves was the one who sent the first potter plant.
Yeah. Okay.
So Edelwine's not.
No, wait. We don't. We don't know that the Mars Elves were the first one to send the potter plant. We tied Etelwine to the Maskells because we found the picture of the 8 in one of the caves.
Yeah,
but they had nothing to do with her.
No, and then like, she was the one that commissioned the port, and the port obviously was related to...
Yeah.
Oh my god.
And also we heard the female voice, right? I will see you soon.
Yes. But that was like...
That was her.
No, it wasn't a female... Wait, no, it was.
Yeah, it was.
Oh wait, we also know that the Liadons are working with
the king.
Yeah.
We know that the bishop burned your shit down.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Yeah.
The bishop was involved in here also, right? In Valhalla also, right? Was it? We found a journal or a ledger in Acosta's house as well. Oh shit, we were supposed to go and talk to his family.
Oh!
Ooh.
Actually forgot.
Actually clutch.
Whose family?
Acosta's family.
Oh wait, that was so long ago though.
No, that was today.
No,
that was today in game time. So long ago.
Okay.
The pot says the king thanks you for your service. Then underneath the carpet, we found a tomb that says Bishop? Then the rest of the tomb is, yes. Yeah.
Okay. Let's go talk to
Acosta. Mrs. Acosta.
Yeah.
Need the dungeon.
Yeah.
Okay, you make your way down to the royal dungeons. It takes you some time to find it, but you do eventually get there. The guard is there. Look at you, says, do we have an appointment?
We do, right? We actually do.
You here to see someone in particular? Team barbecue.
I wish, but alas, not me. Yes, we're here to see Necromancer Lord Acosta's family. We were clean mentioned that he would send word.
Yes, oh, you are very late. That was supposed to be early in the day. This way, he leads you over to what appears to be a well-furnished cell by prison standards. Two beds, proper kind of like a dining table, kind of makeshift wooden chess set set on the table. It's a young girl who's fiddling with it. Kind of like half-eaten meal on the table as well. For a prison, it's rather comfortable. There's no entering. You can speak to them from this side. And the guard walks away. And he, before, takes like a couple of steps away and he says, make it quick. 10 minutes. Prisoners have to sleep by a certain time. You see the woman turns around, looks at you. Looks confused. And then the girl points at Vervin and says, Mommy, it's a bear?
I wave.
Oh, so cute.
Without saying a word.
How young does the daughter look?
9 or 10.
Okay. I whisper very softly to myself, below.
Your quick billows. The girl screams.
Wait, it's supposed to be a magic trick.
The guard comes running back. We try not to alarm the prisoners, please.
I'm sorry. Apologies. It was just a magic trick. A harmless one.
He's like, no magic in the prison, please.
I'm sorry.
Before I throw you out.
I'm sorry. Please.
Walks away again.
Wow.
Yeah, off to a strong start.
Hi there. We are.
I'm sorry, I can't say me and my daughter know who you are.
Oh yeah, this would be the first time we meet. But well, we were looking into the disappearance of your husband.
Well, if you do find him, could you please tell him that honestly, he's ruined our lives. We've been stuck here for weeks because of him.
Yeah.
Could you tell us more of like what happened exactly? We just want to hear your side of things.
Oh, it started with one day he had a delivery. It's this stupid plant. He brought it in, brought it up to his study, started watering it, and it was a strange plant. He said it was supposed to look like that. I've never seen anything like that before.
What
did
it look
like?
The thing is, it didn't show itself when I was around, apparently. When I was around it, the buds were closed. But the way my husband described them, he said they looked like eyes. he drew the eyes on the notebook and showed them to me once. I don't think plants are supposed to have eyes.
Do you know who sent him this plant?
He rattled on about a bishop of some kind he went to. He went to procure a chess set just to examine the actual chess piece. And then he started playing chess with my daughter. At first it was harmless. First week. So he got very into chess. He started playing with my daughter. My daughter loved it. And gestures to the chess on the table.
At first it was harmless. Did it become harmful?
He couldn't sleep. At night he would shake, tremble, scream, stop looking at me. You would see he would wake up, and then she kind of like gestures with inverted commas, wake up from his sleep, his eyes would be bloodshot.
This is seeming pretty familiar to what we've been dealing with.
He lost his appetite, refused to eat even his favorite food. He would try to drink as much as he can to force himself to sleep, but it didn't work.
You said he received the plant from a bishop.
Funny thing is, when she interrupts you, the funny thing is I tried to get rid of the plant. I did try to get rid of it once. Threw it out. When he came back, he hit me. He said he wasn't done with it. He slapped me when I got into an argument with him. He went out and looked for it, and it only took him 2 minutes to find it. It was almost like he knew exactly where I left it.
Well, I think you would find it easy to believe us when we tell you that he was not entirely in control of himself during this period.
I suspected as much, but He ruined our lives. You have to understand. My child can't go to school. We lost our home. We've been in this cell for weeks. I have not seen the sun in weeks.
Well, if it brings you any comfort, it really wasn't your husband that put you all through this, which is why we're here, and I think it's more important to understand.
Can you get me out of here?
We don't know. But it's more important to understand what was he working on in the weeks leading up to this plant arriving.
If you get me out of this cell, I'll tell you. You have to promise me.
Is the guard around?
No.
Should we?
I could break her out now.
I
want a pardon, and I want my home back, and I want my life back.
Maybe we could ask Flynn. I think. Well, the only reason she's in here is because the Triumvirate were, I don't know, looking for a co-star, but I'm sure this can be reasoned with, Clint.
Yep.
We'll secure your release, but this information that it's important, it's urgent. You must...
I will not speak until I have your word I will be pardoned. And my daughter will not see the inside of a cell after today.
I'm gonna check my spell book.
Well,
my imaginary spell book.
We can speak to Lin, right? And then like if we can come back if it's alright.
Sure.
We don't have to.
I'm a bit out of the loop, right? Maybe I wasn't paying attention, but why are they in prison for? Like the whole family?
Like a bargaining chip.
They were being
detained.
Yeah.
Okay, but it's none of their problem, right?
Yeah, I mean it was under the basically a low-key threat, right? To Kosa.
Yeah, like, yeah, which makes sense, but it's inhumane.
Well,
have you been
fucking triumvirate?
This is the least inhumane thing that has happened.
Maybe we could convince Clint.
Yeah, this which is what I think you should.
Perhaps, yeah, we could convince Clint.
Yeah.
And we've already helped him out a bunch, and we've. Well, not really helped him out, but yes, helped him out.
Dumped more shit.
And also, dumped more shit. I mean, he probably is thankful that, like, deep down inside, that we've told him some of this.
Hey, we gave him what he wanted, so. He can't complain.
Hmm.
Okay, well, okay, that fine, I guess we can stay for a while longer. I hate this city, but...
Looks like we're gonna be here for another day, at least. I mutter under my breath. Low-key, when we come back, they're all dead. With carvings in their backs.
I just like... Yeah, I was thinking that, so I was actually thinking maybe one or two of us should stay at least like...
No!
Why?
What do you mean? Like stay and then the rest of you go back to Everest?
No, for the night!
Oh.
No, like...
Oh my god. Oh, as in stay here to like guard them?
Yes, I mean, I don't mind. I can't.
Let's just all stay here.
No, I will stay. How about the rest of you?
No, we're not doing this alone.
Okay, well, I will stay with Oricus.
Let's all stay.
Couldn't we keep someone that can contact us quickly down here? I look at Isilia.
Huh?
If shit goes down, we're gonna need help, right?
Uh-huh.
And who better to ask for help than you? You know, with your kid voice.
I said, like, we can. I think we all should stay here. I don't think we should split.
Then how are we gonna get Clint to? How are we gonna get Clint to pardon them?
We can.
I could break them out. No, we can all go together.
Now? We can do three. Three of us stay.
It's like 9 PM. He might still be awake.
Three of us stays here and two of us.
Two of ascending?
No.
Yeah, three of us stays here. And if you think we can catch Tlin before he goes to bed.
If anything, I would ping you all.
I think you should go and talk to Tlin this year if the rest are gonna stay here.
And how will you let me know if something's gone wrong?
You've come back to find us with carvings on our backs.
Oh my god. Really? Guys, that is such a vote of confidence.
You could send Reason. If you die, Reason will disappear, right? Or if you fight. Send Reason with Isilia.
I could, but how would the animal know how to find her? It's hard.
No, I mean you send Reason with her if things get out of control.
It's only 1 kilometer.
How far are we away?
1 km is not a long way.
Okay.
Yeah.
The teleporting
corridor.
Yeah, teleporting communication only lasts that far.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, I can go. I can go, the rest of you stay, and I'll go and find him.
No. Then what happens? Yeah, you can't go alone. Yeah.
Okay, fine. Whoever. And then we'll just make quick haste, okay?
Okay.
Yes, okay. Start off at a gallop towards the castle, whatever it's called, palace, something.
You guys have my mount. You can take the mount.
Okay. Can we both sit on the mount?
Sure.
Hi.
It's an unusually intelligent steed.
We'll greet it.
Why don't your steed make the investigation check?
Okay. Alright. Okay. Who's going to Who's going to see Clint?
Yeah, me and...
And... Jessica, yeah.
Pinstripe just hanging around.
You smell blood.
What?
Oh my god!
I'm just kidding,
You fucking... Oh my god, dude. I would, like, if that actually happened, I would just say, yeah, guys, let's just leave. Let's just leave.
Escape logout.
Like, we just go to the ruins, we fireball the door, then if the fireball doesn't work, then we just go back to...
Alright, you see Clint getting ready to locking up the his office, and it's like, he sees you approach, and it's like, again?
Hi.
Hello?
Sorry.
Yes. It's very late.
Yes. Do understand. A lot of work to do. We were wondering if it was possible to have Acosta's family maybe taken out of prison.
Why would I do that?
Well, why would you keep them there? What are you keeping them there for?
Oh, number one, the noble families are pretty pissed that we lost our, you know, one of the key members of state, and they want to send a message.
Okay. This is a wife and her child. They don't really hold no threat.
The way I see it is, if he knows that his wife and children are in jail, it gives him more incentive to come back to save him.
He's not coming back.
How do you do not?
Because he's halfway across the Forgotten Realms. And I know that for a fact.
So I'm supposed to just let them out and piss off noble families in the process?
Tlin. Like, whatever you do now, you have the power of the throne behind you. You can do whatever the fuck you want. Like, be a good person.
That is true.
I mean, think of it this way. Think of how... Okay. Kesklav with intel, you wouldn't know this word. Think of how benevolent you would look to them.
Come on, you're young, but you're not dumb, okay?
Oh, he is pretty dumb.
All kind of dumb.
Think of how nice, like, you would look to the citizens, like, letting a innocent daughter and mother out.
I could do it as a show of strength, honestly.
Yeah, exactly. After all that they went through.
And then remember, she would then be indebted to you.
She's pretty useless, honestly speaking. There's no intrinsic value in that woman. Only her husband had value.
Yes, but you see, if she is indebted to you and she is the key to her husband, she in turn would be of value.
But her husband's missing.
Well, only you know.
Who has the strongest ties to her husband? Would it not be her? Wouldn't you then
Then you are saying that the husband is halfway across the world and not
I'm
coming back?
Saying that let her be your bargaining chip, but keep her happy so that she's willing to aid and support you.
Maybe Acosta.
But if you keep her like miserable, then when you reach out to her for help, which will inevitably happen with anything related to her husband, then she's not gonna want to help you. So if you now put her in a position of comfort and ensure that her daughter can go to school and be protected. Then if anything hits the fan, she's gonna be like, yeah, fuck you, husband. Like, I stand with Tlin because he was here to support me and our family when you abandoned us. So she is the best bargaining chip for you against him. Do you see?
But...
I see. Hmm. Okay.
Well, yeah, and you know...
I will write up a pardon first thing in the morning.
Now, please, Tlin.
Please, right now.
We're not there.
I have fucking locked my office. I am not unlocking the office. I will write up a pardon first thing in the morning.
Persuasion. Persuade him. Persuade him.
I will. I can't. My position is negative one.
Okay, maybe a persuasion check.
No, Kaskla! Please!
No.
You would have won that open.
Do it! Convince him with some manga leaves. Manga leaf tea.
I mean, if the DM just allows me it. To. I'll roll if the DM allows me to.
No.
I literally didn't get a chance to say anything.
Oh, sorry.
Alright, tomorrow morning, I will write out the pardon and we will have her to facel when I get to office. And
what time is that exactly?
I don't know. Whenever I get to office and I do the pardon. Maybe before lunch. He nods.
Fine.
Have a good evening. And he walks away.
Thank you, Finn. Well, I mean, at least he said you. Just officially won't get it until tomorrow, which sucks. And I don't want to stay here, but what else can we do?
Maybe we can just, you know,
just break them out now.
Can let them know.
Yeah.
But that's just gonna cause so much trouble for them. Like, why the fuck?
Get back on reason.
Okay, you return.
Got the pardon. It will physically be written up tomorrow because it is past working. So it's happening. It's gonna happen. You would, if it assures you, and I'm telling this to Lady Acosta, whatever her name is, the current ruler is very much indebted to us. So when it's gonna happen, I assure you it's gonna happen. He just will get it done during his working hours tomorrow morning. So in the meantime, can we expedite the process by getting the information so that we can then...
Oh, make me a persuasion check.
Oh my god!
Why you open your mouth?
Next time I'll keep quiet!
You gotta remember these things, right? Because...
Fine.
Whoa! She nods quietly, says, I don't know why I'm trusting a random stranger. Perhaps if I find out that you are lying, maybe it's true and there are no good men and women left in this world. My husband was working on resurrection.
I feel like that wasn't news to
us.
I
don't know what you understand of resurrection and the limits of resurrection. My husband was working on something experimental. Even with magic, the extent of bringing back someone, the person's corpse can only be as old as 200 years. My husband was working on something which would bring back corpse from even 2,000 years old. And something that would honestly revolutionize modern magic corpse would be whole and their memories would continue as if the person had never passed.
Do you know who he was trying to resurrect?
He was not trying to resurrect anyone. He was trying to revolutionize the way we think about magic.
How does the plan come into play?
It doesn't. He was already working on this way before the plan arrived.
And someone caught wind of it?
She shrugs.
So this plan didn't come from business associate. But a stranger?
Was he surprised when he received the plan? Like, oh, what is this? Who is this from? Or it was like...
He was surprised to get it, yes. He didn't know who it was from. But he started to address the person by the name Bishop. As if that's supposed to mean anything to me.
When he received this plant, did it already come in the sand gem pot?
Yes.
I whisper to the party, that makes no fucking sense. The pot was a thank you gift for his service.
Maybe it's a cheeky kind of thing, you know, like King thanks you for your service that's about to come.
Like he was working on revolutionizing something and that's exactly what they're trying to do and they're thanking him for doing.
Possible?
You know, like of kickstarting the process, I don't know.
Did he drop all his research when he received the plant? You said he became obsessed with chess and the eyes.
He did try to continue his research and initially he was still working on it, but as he grew more and more tired, it became hard for him to sustain his focus and attention. Eventually, he just gave up.
Where did he keep his research? He didn't find anything in his house, did he?
No.
Nothing of note.
If you didn't find anything, it was either confiscated or he took it with him.
And normally it would be in his study, I assume.
She nods.
Why was he so obsessed with resurrection?
Like, for many, the idea of immortality speaks to them. For my husband, it wasn't so much about living or extending his life. It was really about making a breakthrough, and he had an affinity with, well, necromancy and resurrection-based magics. It's just the way it is.
Did he work on this on the behest of the Triumvirate?
For the Triumvirate, he was creating an army. He worked on that. This was his own personal project.
His personal project was to create an army.
No.
His personal project was to create an army for the Triumvirate. No. His personal project was this resurrection thing.
Yeah.
His work project is to create an army for Triumvirate.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's crazy. Etheline bought a diamond.
Yeah.
5,000... Gold
she
diamond.
Needs him to continue his work to resurrect whoever she wants to resurrect.
That's crazy.
Or maybe
Ooh.
She is like possessed or maybe this is like, I don't know, maybe she, I don't know, it's either resurrecting somebody or resurrecting herself. Do you know what I mean?
That's crazier. I like it.
Do you know what I mean? Like she, like she's a young girl, right? Like she's portrayed as this young girl, but what if she's not a young girl? Like what
she's
if
a
she's
lich.
Trapped
what
in
she's
a young
a
girl's body, and then she's trying to get back to like her OG source? And,
why being young,
you know,
Clarissa?
I don't know.
Don't understand if why. Why then give him the plant?
It's like a I
Does
see
it make
you.
His
I,
mind
I recognize
pliable.
Your
yeah, exactly.
achievements. You know, I think you're cool. And then he then becomes like sort of not say indebted, but like because the reason why he's doing this according to Lady Acosta is because he wants recognition, right? He wants to show the world that hey, you know, I made this thing possible. It's not the actual fact of doing it, is like I am the one who made this possible.
No, but also like without the mind voodoo, why would he ever leave here? He would just stay right where he is.
That's true, because he has a family.
Yeah. So it's also about that. So what then did she want with Yin?
He was a botanist.
But we don't know if Ethelwine actually had contact with Yin, right? For all we know, it came through the Liodons, the plant.
But like the plant seems to be like her calling card, you know?
I mean, it doesn't matter, right? What do the eight one with? Botanist, a planeswalker, and a necromancer.
Body is another plane. Did they go and get it?
Because Yin's disciple student thing traveled the plains and she knows a lot about plants. And then she something gave him something about the legendary plants. Something my spell slot's gone.
Why?
Elha's flow destroyed. It all links together. I'm really struggling here.
I don't know.
Anyway.
What else can we ask her?
Great. Fantastic information. Thank you.
I don't want to buy the diamond. Runs away with him in the forest.
Do you know how far Costa has gone with his research? Is he close to being successful?
The last time I spoke to my husband, he told me he was on the verge of a breakthrough. Very close. But since then, after the plant arrived, we never really spoke about his research. He was more interested in eyes, bishops.
Pardon the, I suppose, insensitive question, my lady, but your husband, was he a talented spellcaster himself, or merely the academic sort?
My husband was very skilled necromancer. Now, I know a lot of people frown upon necromancy, but there are people who use it for good. My husband was one of them.
Great, so we have like a ninth level caster running around with some crazy terrorist teenager.
Mm-hmm.
The only solace I have is that whatever the necromancers bring back, I can smite.
Just, did he ever tell you?
Wait, but if you resurrect, it's no longer undead, right? Yeah.
Did he ever tell you what he was so close about what he was missing? You know, like he was so close to a breakthrough, but if only he had. What was the if only?
He said whatever he needed couldn't be found on this plane.
And you don't know what is it he's looking for.
She shakes his head.
How would he know that it's not on this plane? How would he know what's on other planes?
He said that this particular reagent that he requires, he has not heard of it, and he's spoken to several experts on the subject matter. They said that this particular, what he requires, does not exist on this plane.
What is it he requires?
A specific focus.
Do you have a name?
Focus?
She shakes her head. Something to channel the spell, but I know there is a focus for him to channel the spell, but I don't exactly know what he calls it or the component. If you have his notes, I could point it out to you.
Do you know who he consulted with?
He spoke to me briefly about his work, but I didn't really pry.
That's fine.
If you do find his notes, it should all be in there.
Hint, hint.
Maybe you can ask him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Ask him what?
Maybe he could do another sweep of his house.
Can we ask the jailer about like the evidence of like the belongings? Yeah, I'm sure it's...
Yeah, let's try that and then...
I'll have a quick word with the guardsman.
Yes, before you leave, she says...
I will thank her.
I hope you were not lying, and if you did help, thank you.
We're not lying.
I don't know. Are you lying, Isilia?
Could I also just take a closer look at the chessboard?
It is a wooden chessboard from this far away. You can't tell without asking her to bring closer to you or anything like that.
I'll just ask her if there are any markings on that chessboard.
It's a normal chessboard my husband bought from her.
Strange etchings.
No, nothing.
Do you mind
base of the pieces?
Do you mind if we take a look?
Sure. She kind of brings over, shows you. There's nothing too strange about it.
The base of the pieces.
No, nothing. It's just a normal looking chessboard.
All right then.
Really?
Is it magical?
Is it missing pieces?
No, it's not missing. He says, guys, not everything is a clue.
I stare at the chessboard.
You approach the guard and you ask him about the research notes. He says, when we got to the apartment and we cleaned it out, there was nothing there. On the desk of whatever you speak of, it was empty already.
He must have left with it. That makes sense.
Oh, Ether Wine got to it first.
He's with him, so... it will make more sense for him to take it. I mean, if they are going to continue the work that he's doing, he will need his notes.
That's troubling. That's very troubling.
So it will make sense that he took it.
Why? Why resurrection?
How does this tie into Netheril?
No, Netheril is past 200 years ago.
You know what, if you pass through Grey Cloak again, maybe you can pop by the king and ask him some questions.
It's Selby
no,
did, by the
we
way.
Did, right? Yeah.
But we didn't ask him specifically.
I did. I remember asking him about the agreement.
Really?
Yeah, he says
how do we know about the agreement?
No, there was a link between the cities, so I asked something like that, and then I believe the reply was like, I'm just a simulacrum, right? I don't have the full information. You are not actually talking to the first Lord of Everesca, we're talking to like a remnant that fulfills a singular purpose.
He didn't say he's not someone, he just said he could not remember the information. Yeah, but yes, you are right.
Okay. Well, I guess we bed down for the night. get the thingy pardon tomorrow and then fuck off.
Alright, anybody need to do anything else?
You don't need
to get the pardon. The pardon will be issued. You don't need to get the pardon physically.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Okay. Great.
To be safe, are we staying here? Like, hunkering down in the dungeon with him?
Nah, we got all the information we need.
Dungeon?
I'm staying.
Let's take a rest somewhere else.
Oh, Kessler, are we? Staying.
We're not going to... The bazaar?
I don't have anything I need. I'll stay here.
Okay, those who want to go to the bazaar can let me know what you want to do.
Sorry, I was talking to my mom. Are we still guarding the cell?
I will stay. I just don't really want to see people die. Out of earshot of them, of course.
If Kasta's staying, I'll stay.
Okay.
Who has all the stuff to identify?
Not me.
You.
Don't really feel like I should go though. But I suppose I will. I suppose I will.
If anything, I can ping you.
Sure. So who's going with me?
I'll go with you. I wanna surprise Gogal.
Oh my god, yeah! The last time we saw you, you were dead.
Guess who's back?
Your back favorite again. Elf.
Alright, okay. Alright, let's find a vendor to identify. How many items do we even have? I don't know. I mean, there's a sword.
There's
crimson.
Cursed, yeah. Right?
You don't know that.
Yeah. No, wait, didn't you?
You can best.
I know it's cursed, yeah.
You can best be assured it is cursed.
No, I know it's cursed.
No, yeah, you divine sense, right?
Yeah, I just don't know why or how. What? Okay,
what items? It's 15 gold per cast of identify.
I'm gonna like bargain it down to 12 with a handshake.
Sure.
How many
ten
casts?
Ten.
Huh?
Three lah, three. We.
What are you identifying first? Crimson?
Wait, what do we have to identify? Crimson, amulet of proof, do we know already?
Yes, that
yes.
Was way before.
It was
done
already. It's only crimson actually.
Yeah, that's the only thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go for pen.
Yeah.
With plus something or whatever?
Yeah, it's the plus the...
1d4? Ooh, roll properly on the d4, let's go.
Sure, 10 gold.
Right.
Call it even 10 gold.
Right.
Very persuasive man you are.
Could I also persuade you to maybe put on some gloves while handling this thing? I have a feeling that whatever enchantment befouls it is...
How about you just leave it on the table and I don't touch it?
Excellent. I'll do just that.
You seem mutter the incantation and cast identify. Sir, it's a... Well... Curse blade first of all. The matter of the curse, it's interesting because this weapon is sentient.
You see this look of disgust cross my face.
It has a mind of its own. That is it's a living weapon.
Like it's possessed or?
No, it is a creature of its own. It is not possessed. If it was possessed, I could perhaps purge it, decurse it. This is a sentient weapon. It is not a curse. The weapon itself is a curse. I can't decurse this.
Would you be able to advise us on what would happen if my friend here, for example, wields the blade?
You're welcome to try, he smiles.
Guess that, no.
You know the benefits, so he tells you that if you use the blade, you will heal. He basically gives you all the positive attributes
of
the blade. Yeah.
But he doesn't know the negative attributes.
No.
Cast it into the fire.
River Styx.
I don't know, man.
Could I observe the blade? I mean, I'm gonna let Seyfried know, like, I'm gonna whisper Seyfried, hey, I could always remove the curse, you know, but I'm not sure if the potency of my my spell casting ability
is
enough.
It's not cursed, right? You just say it's not cursed. Does it work? I mean, we don't know, but what if you remove curse then it becomes a red stick?
Okay.
It becomes a long sword.
Then isn't that good? That means it was cursed, right?
Oh, man. I don't know. In character, I would not let anyone use this without you decursing it.
Yeah, I will.
Out of character, having one of you with a floating sword and with a blood test sounds kind of cool. I don't know.
Use it!
Pick it up!
Decurse!
Mr. Z will talk to you. It's your call, Mervin.
Cuff and I are just sleeping.
I look at both of them. And I just grab the blade.
Whoa, whoa.
You grab the blade?
I grab the blade.
No, I've got an initiative check to sort his hand.
Sure, you can initiative check this.
What the heck? I'm not a very fast man.
Oh. Am I supposed to roll also?
Yes.
You could just give up and not. Oh my god.
He grabs the blade. You put in the R channel for a second.
Oh my god.
Yo. Let's go.
No.
Let's fucking go.
This is it.
Oh no.
I should have just decursed it.
You should have just initiative check too to launch the spell.
Oh, I mean, it's a blade, isn't it? I feel like if DM wanted to bait me into using it, right, he would have made it a mace or something.
Not you.
No, not
but
you.
Bait Arcus into using
Arcus,
it.
Man.
You
I
had
know,
two
but...
campaigns of it.
Yeah, right? I know, but you know what I mean, right?
Yeah, there's someone else because for change. You be a nice, holy furball is what we need.
Teddy bear.
It's the balance
the children.
That we need in this campaign.
Guys, I'm struggling. Struggling.
I'm tired. So I am so tired of being in this stupid city. Just wanna get the fuck out.
I'm struggling.
Also, we are on a time crunch, by the way, to get back to everyone.
Yeah, fuck it lah. Time crunch. Verona can wait lah.
I don't give two shits.
She want us so bad, right? She can pot her bitch
yeah,
ass down
can,
here.
Yeah, come and get us lah. You clearly come, know
yeah.
your way around.
Yeah. Can come and make us forget about this murder we are trying to solve.
Some of us do so many things for her, then when finally did ready, then she's like, hey, can you come back now or not?
Chibai. I want to go and find Nenuan, can or not? We cannot go, up me.
Hey.
Now we got Crimson Blade, I think we are very well equipped to go and find
Nenuan. Hey. Then you all mind wipe new campaign.
Are you from Netheril?
Gone, I tell you.
Did it.
What the heck?
What the heck? What? Why he say? Why he type ya? What is ya?
Yeah, he knows that he has a plush tree.
Oh, what the heck?
This is the most value skill, eh. I've been level 6 for like 5 minutes and we've banged this out like 8 times already.
Pause champ.
Pause champ.
Pause champ.
Okay, who have to be smite?
Hello, hello.
Hello.
The you see
me right?
As Oracus grips the blade, for a brief moment you see almost like this pained expression appears on his face, cold sweat running down his brow, before you see the sword light up with crimson energy. Just glow, this beautiful radiant crimson glow for a brief flickers for about 5 to 6 seconds before fading, and then just a regular red metal.
Whoa. Whoa.
His name is Crimson.
Yeah, don't give a shit, man. What? Ooh. You okay?
I am.
Are you? Got divine sense.
You got divine sense, what?
To make sure he's not like goddamn vampire now.
No, he's not.
Alright, you're clean.
I'm clean.
Well, you put the thing away.
Okay, I'll put it away.
Well, it's sentient, right? Well, what's it saying?
I wonder if this is what Kesglav experiences. Is Crimson my Nelor now?
What's he saying?
Well, it seems like I don't know who created him. Seems like he allows people to wield him. He's looking for a strong owner, if you will. Strong wielder.
Stripping young lad, who wouldn't want that? Well, what's he telling you to do? Is he telling you to stab me?
No, he's not telling me to do anything, but he did say we will speak again when he draws blood.
Why don't you test it out right now?
Why don't you draw blood for the blade right now?
Yeah, just like nick the shot.
On you?
No.
Alright, hit me.
A little scratch.
Go for it.
Wait, is Vervain with us also?
Yeah.
So it's only Kesglav at the...
No, at me.
Oh yeah, let me see, yeah. Are you sure, Vervain?
Ice night out, let's go.
I will scratch the bottom of my chin and...
Maybe we should do this somewhere else.
It's just a little bit.
Oh, hold on. Maybe this should be reserved for an enemy, alright? What if something terrible happens to the person you cut? I wouldn't want... Yeah, let's not. Let's not test it on ourselves.
Did anything happen to you when...
No, he didn't.
Crimson cut you?
No cutting. There will be no cutting.
Oh, but Crimson did cut you before, right?
You don't have to remind me. He also cut you very badly, actually.
Oh, yeah, he did.
So why don't you ask that out?
Something bad happened to me, but...
Alright, put it away.
Maybe not through the hands of Crimson.
Put it away.
Okay, I'll wrap it up in a blanket.
Hold on. Before you wrap that up, could I take a look at it?
Sure.
You
wanna hold him?
Yes, I'll hold him.
Give me a constitution saving throw.
No, as in, I'm gonna hold it and...
Yeah, your constitution saving throw.
Alright,
18.
Okay.
You take 10 necrotic damage as you are blown back by the blade. Oh. And the blade hovers in place and floats back to Oracus.
I was gonna cast Remove Curse. Could I not cast that in time?
You don't have to touch the blade to cast it, right?
I do, it's just as you add your touch. Yeah, I'll post the spell.
You can try touching it.
Yeah, I was gonna touch it and do remove
nothing
curse.
Happens, you get blown back, you take 10 necrotic damage, and the blow hovers in place and floats back to Oracus.
I see.
Sweet.
That's a very powerful blade you have there, Oracus. It seems to hate everybody, including me.
Oracus, what's he saying now?
I tried to listen. Do I hear anything?
No.
I just shrugged.
This is cursed, and not literally because I just tried to
bleeding,
remove cursed. No.
He's a big boy, he can take a bit of a...
Yeah, I'm okay.
He's not saying anything!
Well, Oracus...
Maybe because Vervain isn't bleeding.
the sword is not cursed. And I can tell you that with confidence because I just tried to use remove curse and it isn't cursed.
That's what the man we paid 10 gold said.
The man looks over the content and is like, is your friend stupid or something?
I'm gonna...
There's a little try.
Secret flame him.
Dispel magic, dude. I'm gonna dispel magic the sword.
Don't do that! Stop it.
No, I'm not going to. I'm just kidding.
Put it away, both of you.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. I just won't do it. I assume that it's attuned and it'll just attack whoever is not attuned to it or something. Some of the sort like that.
Wow, how did you gather that? That's very astute, sir.
What do you mean? Isn't that how all...
God, how many? Isn't that how... is the king of cursed items.
If it's not cursed, right, it means it's just a magical item that's just attuned, right?
Yes. Amen.
Okay,
but it's also a sentient magical weapon.
Sure, okay. Yeah, that's completely fine. So as long as it's not cursed, if it's like magical and it's attuned, that's okay.
Elrond, Mr. Z, Duck.
Hey, you can't draw that parallel.
Serial Duck.
You can't draw that parallel.
Elrond, that's completely fine.
Okay, who was there in that campaign to help me use remove curse or dispel magic? No one, man, no one.
Oh, pointing fingers now.
There was only one person who could have done it.
See, the first thing I did was remove curse. You see, if it's not cursed, I'm like, okay, well, that's fine.
Alright, listen, if it ever tells you to like stab one of us, maybe you give us a heads up.
Sure, I will. Of course I will.
Yeah.
Alright. Let's... Anything else, guys, for the bazaar?
What else do we have to identify?
Nothing, but you said you wanted to perhaps buy the secret. Do you still want to do that or no?
We're flush with gold, right?
No, we're not flush with buying this guy's secret.
No, we're just gonna find out who.
It's expensive.
You didn't get a price the previous time.
175 to find out who bought it.
Oh, I gave you the price here. Yeah.
Wow.
Okay, 175. So...
We only have 1,200 gold left. Alright.
We don't need to pay.
This guy, bro! Now that he's got the curse, now that he's got a weapon that is sentient, he's like...
No. We don't need to kill him either. I'm just saying.
Oh!
He wants to steal it.
Kaskalov not here, right?
We just need a name, right?
Kaskalov being chilling?
Be chilling.
Chilling.
You're not chilling, you're alert.
Yeah, but I mean, after they're done with this shit.
Yeah, but being chilling lah. Oh, you have something, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, man.
I tell you, it's gonna be like, well, I mean, the person will be...
It's your call. I will... I would advise you try to do it behind Cypher's back.
Mm-hmm. If I remember correctly, he doesn't allow more than one person in.
Yes.
Yep. So, I will have to sneak in.
It's not going to be easy, my friend. It's not a very big tent, number one, to begin with. From what you remember of the previous one, the moment you're inside, you're pretty much... There's nowhere you can hide.
So, are we leaving back to join the rest?
Well, I mean, if you guys are not interested in his secret, we can just let it go.
I don't want to pay for it, and I think...
I mean, it's not even his secret, it's just who bought it.
Yeah, who bought it?
If you... I don't know, I'll leave it up to you. But, the ring only can use one time, is it?
Yes.
Ah, then too bad.
Dealmaker's ring, is it?
Yeah.
Once.
I was saying you could try to knock the price down, but you already used it.
It's up to you, man. If you really want to know, it's party money. You get to spend it.
I don't know, I was thinking it might be something important, but... You know, having
spoken to Slynn...
He sold it for 175 to this person. unknown person and he wants to charge me 175 to give me the name.
That is
of
a
this person.
No, that is a racket. Alright, that's a racket.
Mm-hmm.
You can talk to the guy and find out more if you want.
Yeah, we can give it a shot and see.
Okay. You step into the tent. It's the... Well, no, let me pull up my sheet for this thing. You're just gonna change the music and it sucks. Yes? It's not mystery time anymore. Where's my music?
Come out of the tent. Then I see the crimson glowing. I know what happened.
Okay, so again, the same gnome dressed in the old faded robes, sitting in the very small 20 foot by 20 foot room. The orb and the set of scales. Step in. Eh, it's you again. I remember you. You've not been back for a while.
Hi, Edgar.
I can't say I remember your name, unfortunately.
It's okay. All you need to do is remember one name.
What name might that be?
The name of the person who bought Talin's secret.
Ooh, I do remember that name. I have it here. And then he rubs his ledger.
So, who is it?
You know I can't be giving away information like that for free.
What if I exchange it for a secret?
Now, what might that secret be? And how much is that secret worth? You know the drill? He gestures to the orb.
Damn it, should I do this?
Hey, you're in the tent alone.
Yeah. I know the circumstances behind the Triumvirate's death.
The eye. You look into the eye and you speak the words. And you see there is this trail of blue light that forms as the gnome's fingers twirl around it and pulls it to the empty scale. And the light coalesces into an orb that causes it to sink. Then he starts adding weight. Wow, this is a hefty one, huh? Well worth the price, I would say. You have yourself a deal.
What, did he provide a valuation?
Yeah, how much is this secret?
Let's just say it's worth a considerable amount.
Can I
trade in one for one, yes?
Can I eyeball the weights he put on the
quite
scale
lot, yeah,
compared to the
lot.
Time that I sold my secret?
The one, the quite heavy one, is it?
Yeah, so my secret I sold for 75, right? Then this secret,
this is
how many
heavier.
Weight?
This is heavier.
If I look at the weights, can I estimate how much is it worth?
It's at least double.
At least double. Okay, one for one then.
Well, he flips through his books. We are looking for a name, yes?
And information on this person if you have.
Of course. Well, we're looking for a man named Oxley. I will type the name. He's not a local, as far as I know. I had a brief conversation with him. He is from the city of Lorp.
Wait, this Oxley is different from the Oxley that
died.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Different spelling. Okay. Oxley. It's from the city of Lork.
Who else is in Lork?
The Miss Shadow
family
dude.
In Lork. Yeah.
Yeah, the Miss Shadow dudes.
Yep.
Was he a visitor?
It was a long time ago, yes. He came, yes, and he said he was looking for secrets of particular people. He was very specific about what he was looking for. Secrets of people in high political position of the city of Valha. I said I had Flynn's secret. He offered me double, actually, according to my ledger, to sell the secret and make sure that nobody found out. Then he smiles cheekily.
When was this?
This was... He flip. It was 4 days ago.
Wait, 4 days ago? 4 years ago?
Yeah.
Okay.
4 years.
Oxley from Lok. Do you have a last name?
No.
Or inconsequential.
I do not have a last name. He did not give me a last name.
Can you describe what he looks like?
A bit of a pudgy man, if I remember. Don't get many locals. Don't get many foreign people around. Bit fat.
Human?
Yes, if I remember correctly, yes. Quite well dressed. That's all, really. Nothing very outstanding about. Nothing much. No.
Was he old? Young?
Didn't look very old. Middle-aged, maybe.
Did he sell any secrets?
No, just bought and left.
Did you sell him any other secrets besides Tlin's?
I only had Tlin's to offer. I offered him noble secrets, other high value secrets, but he was quite insistent that he only wanted secrets from people with high political standing in Valha.
Hey. Just between the two of us, you don't know what Tlin's secret is, right?
No. Sir, once you use the orb, you can't use it anymore. It's a one-time thing. I don't know any of the secrets. I just buy and sell.
Okay. Thank you. And I just leave.
Mm-hmm.
How interesting.
Where is Locke again?
Let me pull out the map of the region. Yeah.
Oh, wait, it isn't loading for me. Let me refresh.
Oh, that's pretty close. It's pretty close.
Oh, I see.
Well, kinda.
If you see the black line, it's on the same. It's on the same trading. It's basically on the trading route for Anorok.
Oh.
The black road. Yeah.
Okay.
That's pretty close.
Yeah. Not really close, right? Where are we? We are like here. Shit,
we are in like Anorok.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Okay.
They want info.
Lordum. two leads pointing us to Log.
Log down.
What's the other lead?
The Miss other Shadow.
Dying Miss Shadow lady. Was like, oh.
Family lives in Log.
Which we were supposed to see to as well, right?
Well, it was a dying request.
Did we promise her? No, right?
No, it's no. Just a dying request, but you know.
I mean, I would feel okay to fulfill it, but
if it could, I could run a history check for people who have studied a bit to see what you know about the city. Can I get a history check from Vervan, Isilia, and Seyfried, please.
History? But, yeah, history.
Let me think with my mind.
Damn.
Oh, never mind. I don't. Let me think. Nope, Vervan doesn't remember shit.
So, Seyfried, this is what you know. Log was previously known as Shade Point. It was not named Log. But about 12 years ago, it was taken over by an unknown figure known as the Prince in Yellow.
Ooh. And
the city was renamed Log, and it's now affectionately known to... Nobody actually calls it Log. People call it the City of Thieves. And it's a port city at the mouth of the River Greyflow, despite it being notorious for all sorts of vices and theft, burglaries, and so on, and crime. Because it is a port city, and because it's the only city along the Dawn Pass Trail and River Greyflow, it sees the most amount of trade. And because of its prominent location, similar to how like Singapore works, people still have to pass through it, and it kind of like dominates the landscape, if you will. Yes.
Ooh, sounds cool. Wanna go? Let's go, Daryl.
I share none of this with my party.
None of it.
Yeah, no. What's that?
Okay. Sure. So nobody knows anything about Log then, no. Guys.
My team's partner.
Alright then. What time is it right now? Is it finally time for us to rest at night?
I guess so.
Yes,
it's time to rest.
Before we make a break for dawn.
Where are we resting? Oh my gosh. Terrifying.
It's okay to Haskell, rest.
What
at
you
want to
do first? Sorry, Haskellah. Last thing for the.
If, like, just during the downtime with Celia, I'll be. Well, one, working on the wooden source again. Second, I would just have a conversation with her. So while working on it, I'll just. How are you feeling, Celia? I'll just, like, pause halfway and just kind of look at her.
Fine. Bit tired of this city, to be honest. Want to leave, but at the same time don't want to go back to Everesca because Verona. What's her name? Verona, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
How can you forget your nemesis's name?
Lero
Silverhand. Yeah, so kind of in the middle, I guess.
Like if I look at Isilia, like does she just look fucking worn out? Like
I don't know, Isilia, you can tell him.
I guess a little bit worn out, going running around the whole day, like finding the agreement and then having to go back and talk to him again for the part of it. So yeah, I guess a little bit. Check.
I just okay then I'll say I asked just because well I think from when we first entered the city into now everyone's been through a lot but it feels like you don't look Yeah, you don't look as good.
Okay.
No, I mean, it's just you've been under all this pressure, right? Like, you especially with Verona and Evereska's secrets, the whole thing about your brother and, you know, the weird prophecy dream of you getting stabbed. And now being the one to sort of, well, you probably discovered information that no one really had for who knows how long, and you know, now we're trying to probably prevent the end of the world, and that doesn't sound, I don't know, and I'm just hearing all of it, and I'm getting a little stressed out. I can't imagine how you would feel.
Well, when you put it that way, I guess you're right.
It just sounds like a lot on your plate. Like, if it's not Evereska, it's your own life. If it's not that, it's some other weird murder or a plot that you uncovered. And it just, you know, I'm not much help when it comes to these kind of things, but I just thought we've been really busy and never really talked about things.
Thank you for asking, first of all. I appreciate it.
Same.
No, I'm
not even there. Therapy session with Tesla.
To be fair, right? We've played a lot, like, out of character, we played a lot, right? But in character, it's only been, like, what, maybe a couple of weeks?
Yeah.
No lah, more than that. Mm,
I think a couple of weeks isn't stretching it.
I mean, I don't know.
Perhaps
honestly,
we need a break.
Being here helps a lot. And I don't, like, you always kind of undermine yourself, like, oh, you know, I'm young, I don't know anything, you know, I don't come from anywhere, and like, everything is all new, but your perspective is one that I value because it's a fresh one. It's not jaded, it's not, there's no misconception or preconceived notion or judgment, so it's good to have you around to see things from a different perspective, you know.
So I was just checking to see if I understood those words.
Oh. Okay, I mean, you see things differently than we do, and that difference sometimes makes all the difference.
Well,
if that makes sense.
I think it does. Well, I really, I just try to, you know, my mom and dad taught me a lot of things, and I just try to think, you know, about those when I'm, well, in whatever, right? If it's like thinking of like what to do, or even, you know, even fighting. Well, I'll summon the sword. This, I don't think I've told you or anyone, the sword itself, the shape, everything, it's exactly like how my dad's sword looked. He named it Grit, G-R-I-T. He told me he named it that because it was his symbol of having the strength to endure, even to yield, to struggle, to give way, to fight back, to persevere, and his courage and resolve to fight towards his goal. And when I hold it, I just get reminded of all the times he taught me, and, you know, it reminds me of him. And I think you... Well, it reminds me of you too now, like... You show a lot of grit, I think. I think if the sword was to him the symbol of grit, you are to me, I guess, what grit would look like. Then I'll change the form to my mom's staff. And my mom named her staff Penance. She was a follower of Umeta like Bourbon. I think they're a little different but similar in ways. She always told me to be kind and to always be nice, to not hurt people. But she also told me that during her adventuring days, well, there were times she had to hurt people and do anything to survive, right? And the way she described Penance was to be remorseful for the action and to always strive towards repairing the damage that was caused by those actions. So it's not about being regretful or shameful of what you've done, but you know, everything is always towards striking that balance, I guess. And if, as long as what you're doing feels like right to you, that you are bringing more good than bad to the world, that's what she kind of taught me. So I think that feels like what we are doing. Like I think sometimes we do some bad things, but I like to think we are keeping more good than bad to the world.
They sound like lovely people.
They are.
I'm sorry for you.
It's alright. Well, no, it's not really, but I want to find out why this happened and who.
Where are we right now?
So they...
Did we go back to rest already?
This is a scabbard, right?
Like Neluan?
It's original shape, I guess. And then you will it to look like your dad's sword or your mom's staff.
Yeah, I guess so. I don't really know.
That's so nice. Thank you for sharing that with me.
Well, sure.
I think of you as my little brother.
Oh.
Because I am the youngest.
Bro-zoned.
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 Oh,
bro.
That's actually really... yeah, okay.
But anyway, I don't never had younger siblings, so... You know, I treat you like how my brother used to treat me before he went...
Oh.
You know.
I see.
So I hope to pay it forward in a way. He was a brilliant man. He was a brilliant wizard, but... Seems that he kind of lost himself, unfortunately. And I hope that I don't end up following the same path.
Well, we'll make sure you don't. I don't think any of us will let that happen.
I hope so. I really don't want to go back. Can we go do Neloan's thing? Is that really not a thing?
I don't know. I want to find Neloan too, but it seems very dangerous, and I don't know. Wouldn't it be a bit selfish?
Selfish as in to go.
Well, yeah, because I mean, Everesca is waiting for us.
I know. I mean, like, I don't want to go back. It's a personal thing, but at the same time, we are on a mission, I guess, for the city. So it's only you know, fair. I mean, taking your mom's example, to do the right thing, you know, to go back and report, and I guess we will have time to do your thing. But
yeah.
Yeah. It's just me. I'm just delaying the inevitable.
Not really.
What?
Okay, we'll wrap it here for this session. Okay, we'll wrap it here for this session.
I wonder if are we actually gonna set off the next day? Are we going to set off the next day?
Yes, that's the plan, right?
Back to Muha, right? Yeah.
You can change your mind if you want. You can.
Because we don't need to wait for the pardon, right? Like, it's gonna be issued regardless. Okay.
Yeah.
Then we can fuck.
You guys think that there's any anything else in the desert that we haven't covered yet?
So many things, but like
now we have Hidden Stripe, right? We have Hidden Stripe versus, right?
God, maybe Hidden Stripe. We do have to do that too. Yes.
Yeah. Maybe Hidden Stripe knows a thing or two about the desert.
We shall see. Stripe. Yeah, but I mean, we'll be bringing him, escorting him back to Mook.
Yeah.
Well, it's more like he'll be escorting us.
We are his bodyguards. Yeah.
He'll be guiding us, but we escort.
Yes. But I think maybe he would have some interesting things to do in the desert that perhaps we could do on the way back.
This is a player request.
No,
from your favorite forager.
It's not a player request. It's just the thing to note. If not, we just walk back to Wuha. It's like, you know, we have Hidden Stripe. Might as well throw him in the sand a bit, bait some sandworms.
No, you keep this up. One of you will be returning to Everest guy in a bathtub.
Oh my god! Hell yeah!
How about the serial killer? We don't care already.
Huh? I care. I hear. But I also don't care.
Serial killer? Oh yeah, huh?
Yeah,
hey, what are we gonna do about the serial killer?
Open and shut, please.
We have time. We don't have time. We need to get back to Everest. I think we have 2 days. We're down to 2 days to get back. Like, we need to hightail it.
Fuck the she won.
No lah, kind of sunshine. I want to drive a dagger through my heart lah. That's what she wants.
It's too much info.
Dagger
I can't...
that seemed to tear through space, creating a crackling energy. She stepped through the crack and then she sucked the life out of me. That's what's gonna happen.
Uh-huh.
No chance to fight back, gay underground.
Oh my goodness, is that how all these people die?
Oh my god! Yeah. Wait a minute.
Whoa!
Wait, what? Huh?
Whoa,
but we didn't know that whatever used to cut their slit their throats was exceptionally
fast, right?
Sharp, right? Like,
and no one saw it coming.
Unbelievably sharp.
Yeah. Sharp enough to cut a hole in dimensional space, you would say.
Exactly.
Oh my god.
Whoa! Hold up a second.
Okay. Single jet blue eye. Grey cloth covering most of her face.
Single jet blue eye.
Correct. So it's she's it's like this.
Okay.
Right? Something like that. She's wearing a reddish brown cloak.
I sent you the picture, right, man? I think.
No, you didn't.
I did.
Of her?
Yeah.
Did you send it on Telegram, maybe? Is it Telegram or was it
Oh yeah, you... Wait.
Not you, Shin. Oof. Did I not send you?
We pasted some pictures in the chat, but I don't know whether it's official.
I'll send it to you now. Did I not send this?
What else?
I'm surprised.
Cuff black leather armor, utility belt with multiple beautiful ornate daggers hanging from it. There's a scar across the left eye, which is why there's only a single jet blue eye.
Take a telegram.
Jesus.
Well.
But I mean, you know, if I swung the other way, it'd be like, damn girl, mom. But then she's trying to kill me, so. Yeah.
Why? They make the most intense lovers.
That's right. But this is a bit too much.
Yeah.
That looks really cool.
You think you're on top and like, she swipe her dagger.
Think of like Void Wraith times Ash.
Damn.
Together. Oh shit, that sounds great.
Damn.
Not bad, right? Not bad, right?
It's also like a very good cover.
Yes!
Okay.
Yeah, oh my god, might be her. Oh my god.
Oh my.
Oh!
That hits too close to home. It's okay. Isiria is not part of this conversation. She does not know.
What do you mean? What do you mean? This is important.
I know, but I seen like Isiria hasn't put two and two together.
Oh my gosh.
So she's not stressing herself out. Her psyche. Oh my gosh.
That makes one of you.
Alright.
We'll see. I mean, yeah, if it's really her, then she'll probably find us later on anyway.
Why do you think I'm wearing the amulet, bitch? Wearing it to save my life!
What? People don't scry on you.
I don't know, you don't know that. I'm doing it just in case. Just in case.
Oh my god.
Did you upload this episode already? I need to watch it back.
Not yet.
No, I'll go upload.
Oh, okay. You got it.
I just feel like there's some details that I missed out.
Yeah, sometimes when you rewatch the game, you're like, oh yeah, how come I didn't think of this, right? Yeah.
Okay.
You know what you mean.
Okay,
I always watch back, but yeah.
Mine is like I missed the first like 45 minutes.
No, the first
45 minutes is the main part that is important is the middle and the
Okay, that's
fine.
Yeah.
Not much happened actually in the first like half an hour.
Yeah. Just that Oracus got poisoned, that's all.
Yeah, Oracus got poisoned.
Lama.
You drop it, I'll upload it now, Sean.
Okay.